Alright guys, a bit of a demonstration, also a tutorial on learning how to mix dubstep with drum and bass, or vice versa in a sense really. I've delved on this particular subject a couple of times before, but the way I look at it is the more you can explain or the more information you can get out there, the more people will learn. So, right, let's have a listen to this tune. By the way, if you want any more information on the tracks, I'll put the names in the description. Let's have a listen to this guy here. Kit I'm using is on the right hand side the Denon DN-s1200. The mixer is the Pioneer DJM350, and this guy over here is just a USB player. It's from Cam. It's known as the KHD410. It's a desktop USB controller. So, dubstep, drum and bass. Drum and bass tune here. Now at the moment I've got the master tempo on, so I'm going to put that down. Have a listen. Now have a listen when I take the master tempo off. That's quite a nice sort of sound. So, check it out. No mixing, just a bit of editing here. Listen. Tempo, take finger off, cue, master tempo, and then back on with the cue. Bit of filter. Stop that. Now very quickly as well, what we need to remember is the likes of drum and bass, to a certain degree, is quite a fast genre to count. You know, we could count it like, you know, if it's going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, or you could just do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So in a sense, the likes of dubstep is almost about half counting, half time. Now you may have to change the pitch control quite a bit for the drum and bass to mix in well with the dubstep, but in a sense what we're dealing with is drum and bass is almost the equivalent of double time to dubstep. So listen to this. 1, 2, 1, 2. Now can you hear that sort of, almost, it's a bit like a scratching sound in the background. Now you imagine if that was a drum and bass tune. That's almost what we're dealing with. So what I'm going to do is we're going to cue that one up and press play here. Volume up. Okay, I'm just going to go on search. Now we're listening to a drum and bass tune. Now, what we've got, loads of sound. Now, imagine if I was to count it half time as follows. One, two, three, four. Alright, let's wait for the timing to come in here. Just remember that counting. One, two. One, two, three, four. Three, four, one, two, three, I don't know, you wouldn't believe it. It was a blinking cold caller as well, never mind. Right, I've queued this one up. And what I've done with this guy over here, I've got it set for the count of one in a bar. I've just got a random place on this particular tune. Have a listen. So we could count it like this if we wanted to. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Or 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Alternatively, we could even count it like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now have a listen to this guy over here. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Or 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Hopefully you'll see exactly where I'm coming from here. Have a listen. Off cue there slightly. I'll just pause that again. What we do have to consider is there was a lot going on there. One very important factor is, of course, choosing the correct tracks to go with each other. There's no point just getting a drum and bass tune and a dubstep tune and thinking, you know what, I can put it together. They may work perfectly. Then again, if they don't sound correct together, it's probably going to sound terrible. All right, so as usual, in my wacky way, I'm going to try this out. Now, bearing in mind, this is only a demonstration, so if you think it's going to work perfectly, then you're wrong, actually. Well, hopefully what you'll get is an idea of how it should be done correctly, if you practice. Here we go. Right, let's play this one here. Now, I've got this guy at the beginning. Sticker on my foot. Just got someone in the eye then. Right. Now, of course, this is where you'd have headphones on, really. It's gone off there a little bit, hold on. Taking the bass out of this one. Right, I'm going to pause that. Now, again, what you have to... I hate having hairs on my nose. What you have to bear in mind as well is you need to look at particular tutorials, demonstrations like this, and expand on them. Maybe there's one point you'll go, or maybe there's two points that you'll go, or maybe there's no points and you'll go, it doesn't matter. It's about giving a bit of knowledge, sharing some information, and helping. So in this video, we're looking at mixing drum and bass and dubstep. So have some fun and practice and enjoy. I do. Thank you.